Hey folks, welcome back to the channel. And this is part four of the birthing barn build. And this is a timber framed barn that I'm building. And if you missed the first three episodes, I'll post a link here to the playlist. Every time I drop a video in respect to this particular build, I add it to the playlist. So you can just click on them and watch them all until I actually complete the barn. But it's a beautiful fall day here in New England, and I kind of took the day off from work so I can get some stuff done. And I'm gonna finish up the hurricane braces since I got more 2x4s from my wood guy. Thanks, Spike. Thanks, Stan. And I got that one last post there. And I'm going to cut that out and put that in place. And then I'm prepping to install the trusses. And if you could see, I put some 2x3 uprights there. That's going to hold the truss in place. I watched a bunch of videos in regards to putting up trusses. And one of the things they impressed upon that it was a minimum two-man job. But they don't know me. And they don't know how us labbies work. So we're always alone. We're always doing everything by ourselves. And if, you know, we try not to ask for help because I enjoy doing this stuff by myself at my own pace. So when you have someone help you, you tend to have to be a little quicker and more efficient. And that's not me. So thanks for coming back to the channel. Thank you to all the new subscribers. I hope you're enjoying my little shorts, my short videos, and I've gained a bunch of subscribers as a result of those short videos. You get a little peek at what my channel's like, and I hope you enjoy. I'm gonna be bringing more content. And once again, make sure you like and subscribe, and thanks for coming back. So I'm making the assumption that my beam is not level, and that's why this is sticking up this much. Good luck. So when I put my thing on it, it's pretty close. It's between the lines. I put it on the engineered truss. Thank you. So I'm using the, it's a leftover from when I notched out the beams. It's like a 2-inch block. And I'm nailing those up on the top. And that's my stopper. So when I put the truss up, I bump the truss up against that block. And I had so many of those from notching out all the beams that I had plenty to do both sides. And it definitely made it a little easier for when I, you know, putting those trusses up myself, made it easier to have something to bump the trusses up to and then flip them up. Hey folks, thanks for watching my video, and I hope those of you that are interested in building a barn by yourself, you can see that it's definitely doable and possible, and using locally cut lumber, and it produces a beautiful barn. I love working with rough cut lumber. It's a pleasure. And so make sure you like and subscribe my videos, and I'll see you in the next video.